Congo is a country of strategic importance to the United States. It is bigger than Western Europe. It has more than 70 million people. It is also an important source of a whole range of strategic minerals. It has been the location of civil war and even wars that have gone on for decades and have destabilized Central Africa. Congo has just completed its second presidential election since independence from the Belgians in 1960. Those elections, unfortunately, have not gone well. The two leading presidential candidates, Joseph Kabila and Etienne Tshisekedi, both claim to have won. The elections were riddled with malfeasance, with ballot box stuffing, with rigging, probably done by both sides, and a wide range of international and national observers, the Carter Center, for example, the Roman Catholic Archbishop of Kinshasa, have said that the elections were not credible. So there's a standoff. There's a standoff between Kabila's supporters and Tshisekedi's supporters. How do you resolve the standoff? A major political problem in which the United States and other friends of Congo have remarkably little leverage. Under those circumstances, I think it might be wise if the United States were to follow the advice of the Democratic Alliance, the principal opposition party in South Africa, which has said that interested governments should withhold their embrace from the Kabila government until the situation clarifies. A solution is likely to come from African regional organizations. We should be supportive of what they are trying to do. Congo may well be an example of where the only solution is an African solution to an African problem.